Hi, Jim Shaw here from Crystal Group. Spending just a moment today talking a little bit about the MIL Standard 810 testing procedures and processes that are available. MIL Standard 810 is a conglomeration of 24 tests that test a variety of different things. It could be anything from sand and dust, temperature extremes, vibration, shock, a whole litany of different tests that you can do. And it really came about because the DoD needed some sort of a generic test approach that was widely accepted. So a bunch of companies and very smart people from the government got together and said, let's put a generally accepted test procedure in place that industry can use and we can use to go ahead and test the products that are being developed. So the test plan was written for three groups of people, the program managers and the people trying to specify the environment. It was written for the design engineers that are trying to build the equipment. And then it was also written for the people testing that equipment that was being built. And the intent is to try to figure out whether or not the item that's being built is worthy or capable of existing on the platform. So there's an operational, there's a storage requirement, there's a transportation requirement, but all those things are wrapped up into that generally accepted, DoD accepted type of a spec. One interesting note is you can see that a lot of the commercial specs really are spin-offs from that spec. DO-160 is an aviation related spec, but then even some of the IECs that are industry standards or even the European standards tend to emulate a lot of those specifications. So you really can apply a lot of that information to the MIL Standard 810 type of an environment. In revision F of MIL Standard 810, they really kind of broke this up into two parts. The first part was really how do we describe the environment? And then the second part was how do we simulate that environment? And so the part one is really test criteria and tailoring. And then part two is the actual environmental testing and the process. There's an engineering or a program management master plan for how the testing is to be planned out. And you have to think about this from a system level. So let's just pick a UH-60 as an example where you want to qualify a Black Hawk. And then you have to break that qualification down into all the components that are within that Black Hawk and then how to tailor the testing for that. So there's an engineering test, an engineering master plan, there's a life cycle profile, there's an operational environment tailoring. So all of these things up front are really a process for tailoring the testing for each individual item. And then what you do from that is you break that up and create test plans for those items. So those specific test plans then apply to those items. It might be a flight control system, it might be a Gatling gun, it could be a variety of different things, but you're breaking that up into pieces and handing that off to program managers for them to go test. Engineers then create the product based on those test requirements, and then there's a phase in the program where you're actually creating prototypes, and then you're performing the test, and then wraps everything up and brings it back together in a test report. And that's essentially kind of what the introduction of 810 tells you that they're trying to do. And then really you get into the methods and procedures. And that's the meat of MIL Standard 810, because it goes into, all right, this is what we're testing for solar radiation, or this is what we're testing for temperature. And there's usually methods and then procedures that apply, and so it gets very specific. So not only do you need to specify a method and a procedure, but there are variables within those criteria that then allow you to further tailor the process. So we're currently at Rev G, which is 0.7. One of the interesting things is you may look through the document and find out not all of the test plans say 0.7. That just means they haven't updated that plan. So you can kind of track backwards to where the last revision was in the plan. That's just a little bit of an overview of what the plan or what the test procedure is about. And then getting into each one of those test plans is going to be some future GMLN engineering discussions where we're going to dive in a little bit deeper on each one of those test methods and procedures and really talk about what it means to go down that path. One point I would make is the tailoring and the evaluation of all of those different platforms is a very lengthy process. That could be 18 months to get that done. Here at Crystal Group, we just don't have time to go through and every time we get a different platform, test for different environments. So we tend to collect different platforms and put a worst case scenario together and we test to that platform, to that worst case scenario. That might be an AH-60, a C-130, a C-17, all of those things that are combined together. And so where a Dell product might say MIL-STD-810-1G, you know, method 514.6, we actually go in and say, all right, we're going to put all of these different profiles together and we're going to test it to 5.5 G's over this frequency range using these narrow band spikes over top of this broad band power spectral density. And that allows us to qualify several programs at one time. And that's really just a matter of we need to be able to do it very, very quickly. And rather than 18 months, we need 18 days or less. So thanks a lot.
Join us next time for another shiny object at Crystal Group.